And joining us now from the west coast of Florida is Senator Connie Mack. Connie, it's great to see you.
Well, Michael, thank you so much. It's great to be with you.
You know, your book, and I've been reading it and enjoying it, most of these post-career political autobiographies, memoirs, are really pretty bad reading. Yours is not. It's got some very, very good things in it. It's called Citizen Mac, Politics and Honorable Calling. These days, you look at the political life of this country, that bombastic debate that was held on Tuesday, and you say, what's honorable about politics now?
Well, when I told a friend of mine I was writing the book, he asked me what the title was, and I said, Citizen Mac, Politics and Honorable Calling. His reaction was, oh, it's a fiction. So I can understand that. I was raised in a family where politics was, has quite a history. And my mother always referred to her father as an honorable man, and that politics was an honorable calling. And I felt and do feel that it is an honorable calling. Politicians are the lubricant that keeps society moving. And so it's a tough life, but it's an honorable calling.
Yeah. Well, as you point out in your book, and you obviously are a great reader of history, American history, you point out this country has been through crises before, the presidency of Andrew Jackson, the Civil War, the 60s when you and I were young guys coming up, the Vietnam War era. I mean, and we somehow got through this. And you say that the reason we got through this, I'm going to quote you, was the character of the American people and their commitment above all to freedom. That's really your core belief, isn't it?
Absolutely it is. As I say over and over again in the book, freedom is the core of all human progress. Freedom it comes also in a democratic society. And in a free and democratic society, we eventually solve the problems. Sometimes it's messy. And sometimes it takes a long time, but we will solve the problem because we are free people, able to, sometimes very difficult discourse, but we will come to a conclusion. It will move the country forward. And even in these very difficult times, I'm optimistic about the future because we've gone through all of this so many times in the past, and we've come through, we will do it again.
You know, Connie Mack, you went to Washington in, 1982 as a member of the U.S. House of Representatives, and then you had two terms as a U.S. Senator, 20 years in the nation's capital. You made good friends on both sides of the aisle, but you didn't make it a life sinecure. I mean, you did it well for two decades. Then you came home and worked on cancer, the Lee Moffitt Cancer Center, but you... Is part of what's wrong with Washington is that people go and spend their entire lives there?
I think so. I supported term limits when that was the big issue back in the late 90s. Voted for it here in Florida. I forget what year it was on the ballot. But, I've kind of come to the conclusion that I'm not sure that's the right approach. If you believe in free markets, you ought to believe in free markets in politics. So. But I think that to go and to stay there decade after decade after decade, I don't think is healthy. I remember one time kind of challenging my colleagues in the Senate that they really, after 12 years, they really don't have the same sense of what's going on in their communities, in their state, as they did when they first ran. I was adamantly opposed my point of view. But I really do believe I don't know exactly what amount of time, but after a while, you are so caught up with, the environment of Washington, D.C., if you will, it's hard to remember and to know now what's going on. And life in America changes so rapidly. I think that it's better if people have a shorter as opposed to a longer career in politics.
One of the reasons why your career, I think, was remarkable was because you remain and still remain today a civil person willing to listen to other points of view. You had Democratic friends in the Senate like Joe Lieberman and other people. Is that kind of those friendships, those bipartisan friendships, still possible?
I think they're possible, Michael. Of course, it depends on the individual. I would use maybe as an example, you know, Senator Bob Graham and I have become good friends over the years.
Right.
But, you know, we both worked at that. We both thought it was in the state's best interest and our best interest individually, politically, to work together. And I would just encourage others to take a look at that relationship. We also did it because our staffs actually trusted each other as well. And that word trust is so important. Yeah. I never feared that Bob Graham was going to side, what's the word I'm so searching for, that blindside me. We always talked through issues, even though we had differences of opinion, we talked through issues. Yes, it is possible, but people have to want to make that happen. And it's harder today.
I know Bob Graham is fond of you and you remain friends. I think that's pretty remarkable. The book is called Citizen Mack, Politics and Honorable Calling. And if I may say, Connie Mack, you made it an honorable calling. Thank you for your time and good luck with the book.
Thank you so much, Michael. I look forward to the day I'll see you in person.
Me too.